Good evening, everyone. So, as mentioned, I will be presenting today my paper on ImageQuant, wherein we have enhanced the quantitative immunoassay measurement system by way of enhancing on signal processing side. So, before starting with my paper, I will just like to give a brief about our center, which is located in IIT Madras Research Park. And center name is Healthcare Technology Innovation Center, wherein we collaborate with different clinicians, government agencies, as well as industry all over the world, mainly from India as well as from world. You can see most of companies over here who is pioneer and who is developing a lot of instrumentations in biomedical instrumentation area. So, and our research work spans from different technologies, one of which I will be explaining today is in area of POC diagnostic, that is called as point of care diagnostic. And there in point of care diagnostic, we are going ahead with now my paper, wherein I'll be introducing my work and hardware architecture of my work, then software algorithm will be explained, then finally, we are validating entire technology with actual live blood samples, and finally, I will conclude my work. So, as an introduction, I will just give you a brief about immunoanalyzers, state-of-art analyzers. If you see a tabletop analyzers, those are mostly LFIA analyzers. So, LFIA stands for lateral flow immunoassay. So, these lateral flow analyzers are usually with laser and photodiode based system, so wherein you will have one cartridge which is usually a use and throw piece which will have test and control line. So you must have seen pregnancy kits. So that is one form of lateral flow cartridge, but that's like a qualitative kit wherein you will just get answer as yes or no, but in many cases you also need quantitative answer. So for this quantitative measurement, we have developed the instrument, and there are also state-of-art instruments, as I was mentioning, which uses photodiode and laser for this sensing. So in our technology, we have used image a machine vision camera for capturing entire cartridge, which will capture test and control lines. So again, if we take example of pregnancy kit, it will always have one test and control line. So basically, control line will always be present in the cartridge if your test is valid, so that's like validity of your test, and test line will be present or absent based on yes and no of the kit measurement. Whereas in our quantitative measurement, you will always have a test line, but that test line intensity will usually vary in proportional or inversely proportional with your test concentration. So that's what we have to measure by our system. So that test intensity will be measured with reference to a control line. So with going with hardware architecture of the system, we have our system connected with a Windows based laptop or computer or even a tablet system, wherein our main software will be running, which will do a signal processing and analysis. Final measurement will also be displayed on the system, on the computer system. With that, we have attached a hardware which will mainly be consist of imaging camera, and also there are other control elements over there, which includes the sensor switch for detecting the cartridge if it has been inserted or not. Also, there is excitation module which will excite the light intensity on the cartridge for fluorescence measurement. I'll give you a brief about fluorescence measurement in next few slides. So if you see explored view of our ImageQuant chassis, which obviously includes the camera as a sensing, main sensing part, but there is also excitation LED as excitation part for the cartridge. You can see this cartridge in pink color. So there is also exploded view on right hand side corner, which explains the cartridge. So actually, this particular work involves on the instrumentation side, but cartridge is also important part. So I am just displaying the cartridge here to give a brief idea. So that cartridge is like a plastic piece wherein you will have a nitrocellulose membrane inside, and that membrane will have test and control lines over that. So when you have actually dispensed the liquid, means basically a blood or serum sample mixed with some of the reagents, it will actually there will be a biological reaction over there, and which will be finally visible in terms of test and control lines. So, in software algorithm side, we have explained some of the algorithms in previous publications. So, I will not go too deep into it, but mainly those algorithms involves capturing of the image and analysis of the image. But here in this particular paper, we have explained our enhanced algorithm, which removes background flow or basically a background of the test cartridges, wherein which improves our output. Output dynamic range of the instrument, which again I will explain in next slide. So here a brief about detection of this test and control lines. So as you can see in left hand side bottom image, there is a test and control line, plus there is a slight grayish area which explains the background of the cartridge. So that background will actually be used initially for detecting this nitrosolidus membranes inside the entire image. So as the slide says, we will be taking a standard deviation across the cartridge membrane area, and finally we will be finding out the center point of membrane area using these equations. So finally you see mean of this particular standard deviation, means basically a center line will actually be detected, and that center line, if you plot it, which will look like this right hand side top image. So mainly that there is your test and there is a control line. So those two peaks, if we detect, then finally we have found test and control line center point, as well as we know entire area of test and control line based on these two detections. So here you can see mainly test line top and test line bottom. Here you can see center point of test line. So this is test line left and test line right. So finally, if you see in equation which explains VR, so this is like summation of entire area of the test line. This is summation of entire area of the control line. So that's what happens here. When here you can see a test line and that's the control line. So this are different test cartridges. I put together all the cartridges in all three cartridges in one single image here. But this will be like test line for a very high concentration of the TSH. This will be around medium concentration, and this is for lower concentration. So now how we are arriving up to concentration, we will see based on the equation in later slide. But main purpose of this particular paper, wherein we are proposing a modified estimation of background. So initially we used to calculate our VR, and based on this VR we used to calculate final concentration of the analyte. But now those analyte concentrations were giving lower dynamic range for particular tests like TSH, wherein you will also see a large background over here. So basically this light blue area which you see is always the background. So that is also get added when you have this test and control line. So we have designed algorithm to remove that background. So here you can see this is entire test line, and you can see this baseline, which is actually your background. So we don't have any basic model for this. So we need to derive a model wherein it will actually do a linear interpolation and finally remove or finally make this particular region of background. And that particular region will be subtracted from this actual test line volume, and you will finally find out this test line without the background, so which we call as test line minus BG. Same thing for control line also. So that's what is explained in terms of equations over here. There will be initial intensity by linear interpolation, then we are calculating volume of test background. Same way we are calculating volume of control background, and both volumes are calculated here. So now our VR equation, which is VR background removed equation, becomes V test line minus the background volume, which is explained in the seventh equation. So this was our initial equation for VR. Now our new equation for VR becomes my subtracted background. So basically we are removing one constant portion of the test and control line. So obviously that should improve our final dynamic range of the output. So we have tried this thing on different tests. One of them is TSH. So TSH usually suffers from a lower dynamic range, or mainly lower sensitivity range, which you can see here with just a VR. We were getting R of 0.67, and with background subtracted value we are getting R of 0.96. So for this TSH we have measured with 45 different samples, So these samples were actually collected from external laboratories, and those laboratories have measured this the TSH values based on VIDAS instrument. So this VIDAS instrument actually uses LFIA technology, and so now you see based on background remote it is 96 and here it's 0.67. so mainly this lab values we have got from this instrument, which is state-of-the-art instrument, and our volume ratio which we are explaining here for two different algorithms. One was initial VR algorithm, other one is VR background removed algorithm. So that's the final equation. This can be used as calibration equation for the instrument also for predicting the TSH values for unknown samples. So the same thing was applied for another five samples wherein we have done inter and intra instrument measurement, mainly to figure out repeatability of our measurement as well as reproducibility of the measurement. For that we have used two different instruments of or two different prototype of ImageQuant instrument. It's almost done. So we are using two different instruments for reproducibility measurement, and repeatability measurements were done like five times on one single instrument. So that's the COV of all the measurements, and we can see the COV never goes above 6, which is almost accepted by all the standards for TSH measurement. So that's what, as a conclusion, we can see this is the prototype instrument, which is very small compared to any other standard tabletop instrument. And I've already said it improves by 43%. So now this results are acceptable, as we were discussing here. Results are acceptable in terms of repeatability as well as reproducibility. So finally, we are proposing ImageQuant instrument as a convenient tool for any small scale clinical laboratories. Like in India, we can go for any tier 2, tier 3 labs with this particular instrument for different tests. So this is particular test platform. We will be developing some other tests similar to this TSH test for this on the same instrumentation platform. It can also go for tabletop settings on the physician's desk. So finally, I'll conclude with this. If you have any questions, I will be happy to answer.